in right place, right time news.
Ooh. Oh. What a coinkadink.
Submitted by Aloha. That's racist.
What? Why? Racist as
well. A man accused of murder says the show Curb Your Enthusiasm saved him from prison.
How?
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
It's the show from the creator of Seinfeld.
Oh.
Larry David.
I've never seen Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Oh, it's great.
It's coming back. Should I watch it?
You mean a new season?
I think so. I've been hearing. I thought I did hear that too.
But I've been seeing like things.
I think that you're crusty enough that you would really enjoy it.
I'm crusty?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
There's some really funny episodes.
I mean, she's crusty. Like, I'm crusty. She's crusty.
What the fuck is crusty?
You mean you're white enough to enjoy it?
Like white bread crust?
No. Like you see the world. Like, you know, from a darker angle.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
So that's why I think you would dig it.
So that's Krusty.
Yeah.
Krusty the Clown.
And he's dark.
Am I crusty enough?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Okay, awesome.
You'd love it.
Oh, fuck yeah.
We're all pretty crusty.
What's the opposite of crusty? Bubbly?
Yeah.
That's Julia.
Julia's so bubbly, but with a dark side.
With a little bit of crust.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, to be our friend, you gotta be a little bit.
Yeah. To tolerate this.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Oh, thank you. All right, so this story is about Juan Catalan.
I like the name.
A Latin gigolo.
It does. Yeah, so back in May 2003, he attended a baseball game at the Dodger Stadium. And he wasn't supposed to be at that game. He had just gotten last minute tickets. So he was really excited. He went because he loves baseball.
How stereotypical.
Of course, he's Mexican.
Yeah.
But you like baseball?
Dodgers.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That's and the thing. Raiders and
Raiders. They
Cowboys.
Fucking love the Raiders, I'll tell you that.
I already have like three Raiders baby outfits from Gio's brother.
It's getting them young, man.
Yeah.
So anyway, so he took his 6-year-old daughter with him to this game. And then 3 months later, cops followed him home from his work. They showed up, they pulled a gun to his head and told him that he was under arrest for murder.
What?
Turns out that that very same night he was at that Dodgers game, there was a homicide that took place about 20 miles from the stadium.
That sounds kind of far.
It's really far.
It's really far.
To like draw the two together?
Yeah.
That's like, there's a murder in Santa Monica, but you were at the Dodger game, so you're guilty.
Exactly.
Did they know he was at the Dodger game?
No.
I live closer to the Dodger stadium. I'm like less than five miles away. 20 miles is all across town.
Yeah.
I don't know what city, they didn't mention cities, but this homicide, or the person that got murdered, was a 16-year-old named Martha Puebla. She had just testified about a gang murder in which Juan's brother was involved in, and to this date, he's still in jail. And so the authorities were arguing that Juan killed Martha in retaliation. And also there was an eyewitness that said that it was Juan.
Those never work.
Even though his alibi is like 20 miles away.
Exactly. And so Juan got a lawyer, and his lawyer went through a whole bunch of camera footage from the stadium, because he told his lawyer, like, I wasn't even there. I was at this game with my daughter. But they had to have proof.
He didn't have ticket stubs he didn't buy the tickets online.
Can he take a shit and test for a Dodger dog?
Well, this was 3 months later.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, that's a good question about the ticket. I'm not sure. Maybe he threw it away by then.
And well, so, you could buy a ticket and then still commit murder.
Yeah, you could just walk away.
His lawyer kept asking him, like, you know, just can you remember anything else from that night? Is there anything that can help us? Because they couldn't find anything in the surveillance footage from the stadium.
Well, there's like a million people in there. Yeah. Fuck.
Should have been vlogging.
But he could have told him, I walked through here, I sat at here, and then like...
But I mean, he loves baseball, so it could have been from a different time, and who knows. So they just needed like concrete evidence that he was there. He had already been in jail for a whole month, and then that's when Juan remembered that he saw an additional camera crew filming in the area of his, like in his section. And it turned out to be an HBO filming of Curb Your Enthusiasm. And it was the episode called The Carpool Lane, where the character picks up a hooker so he can use a carpool lane to beat traffic to get to the Dodgers game.
That's so fucking funny.
Maybe I should watch this show.
I know, after just reading that little description of that episode, I'm like, I have to see this show.
I saw that episode, it's fucking great. Yeah.
So Juan was in that episode, because luckily, the show's producers, they allowed Juan's lawyer to review their footage, and then they finally found footage of him and his daughter getting back to their seats from going out to the vendor.
Awesome.
So they were extras by accident.
Yeah, but you know what's even crazier? By the time they were trying to get to their seat, the PA that was there almost didn't let them walk back into the aisle because they were in the middle of filming. But then luckily the PA just let them walk through, and they ended up showing up in the footage.
Thank God.
So
PA sucked at his job, should get fired.
That's proof right there.
He was creating movement in the back.
That's crazy how they got that moment.
So the footage seemed like it was a win for Juan, but then prosecutors were still trying to argue that the time of the filming and the time of the murder, he still would have had enough time to go and commit the murder.
In LA, brother?
You know how traffic
is. Friday night?
Yeah.
After a Dodger game, it takes fucking forever to go anywhere in that area.
And he parked at Dodger Stadium? Are you fucking absolutely kidding me?
It's gonna take him 30 minutes to get out of the parking structure.
He had a jetpack, Your Honor.
I know, and that's how he killed Martha. Yeah. Finally, after 5.5 months in jail, he was released thanks to these cell phone records that were finally released because he had taken a call while he was at the stadium and the tower near the stadium pinged that cell phone call. So that, and it was right at the time of the murder, so that saved him. So he finally got out of jail. In 2007, he was received $320,000 in a settlement in for his lawsuit against the LAPD and the City of Los Angeles for false imprisonment, misconduct, and defamation.
Good for him.
That's pretty fucking sick.
It's like, for your time, 320 Gs for 5 months? I'll take that. I'll go to jail for 5 months.
Yeah, it's like you're gonna be in prison at your job anyway.
But what about his butthole?
Oh.
You could've got three sizes bigger.
For your butthole, sir.
Yeah.
That's what the extra 20,000 is for.
So he was suspected to be the murderer because of someone else, like an eyewitness?
Because of an eyewitness? And because of the fact that this girl that got killed,
he was suspect number one
against his brother who is now in jail.
Oh,
that's why cops thought he had a reason to kill her.
So who's the real killer, like his brother's gang friend?
So then in 2008, a gang member was jailed for the murder.
And how did they find them? Like, we're like, well, we thought we had the killer, so we decided to not complete the DNA test. But after we completed the DNA test,
or it's like they just found someone else with a shittier alibi.
They were filming an episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm. And in the background, they caught him murdering.
Oh, shit. Wow.
They actually saw.
On the same day, they panned over.
That's what it says right there. It's crazy.
Yeah, so Netflix has released a documentary of his story called A Long Shot. And I'm going to show you guys. This is what little trailer or like the poster thing looks like.
One murder, one alibi, one unbelievable true story with a Hollywood twist.
Ooh. I'm going to show you guys the trailer for it.
I was slipping through Netflix and I saw this.
Maybe you can find out how they caught the gang member if you watch the documentary.
I saw the baseball theme, the bleachers, and I was like, ah.
Yeah, me too. I actually saw it too, but then I read the story. I'm like, I gotta watch it.
So this whole episode's spoilers, dude.
Sorry. Here we go.
Ground ball at the middle. I love baseball. I can't say that enough. Every time I'm there, I just like, I soak it all in. But I wasn't supposed to be at that game.
That was kind of funny.
That was great. Any other day, but as soon as I opened the door,
see, crusty,
I was completely surrounded, like SWAT style. My daughter, she looks up and she says, "Dad." I told him, "I'm gonna get you out of here." I asked him, "Do you remember where you were?" I was at the Dodgers game. I gotta find the holy grail of Juan's defense. I need to place my client at Dodger Stadium on that night.
He does look what?
He does look like a criminal right there.
Yeah, he does.
When you put him in a jumpsuit, he looks hella like a criminal.
Yeah, he looks really good in a jumpsuit.
So here's Juan with his lawyer that helped him go free. And then this was the footage that they found. So
how did they see him through there?
Oh, here's another one.
That's amazing.
But the back of his head?
Yeah, so you see, and then his daughter. You could see them in the footage. So thanks to this footage and that cell phone tower ping, he got released.
That is the right place at the right
that
time.
That is a long shot.
He's so lucky, man. Imagine how many years of prison time he'd have to serve for like just being associated to your brother.
Exactly.
There's probably a lot of people that are going through that right now. Oh, and they weren't like in public with on tape, you know, like with an alibi.
Nah. And then I feel better at night.
They all deserve it.
Nah, probably not.
I know, can you imagine tonight I'm gonna go to my bed, I'm like, fuck, there's people in jail right now that
don't get to sleep in bed like me.
That's why I'm against the death penalty, 100%.
Oh, I'm the opposite, man.
You're the opposite? Yeah, you're so pro it? It's crazy?
Oh, he's hella pro.
You're like, kill him quickly, kill him now? Oh, that's true. You do that a lot.
Yeah, you know what? Because if that was me going to jail, I'd probably not want the death penalty. So I never think about things like that.
That's true.
You never think if it was me?
Yeah, because...
Man, I'm like, if that was me, fuck that.
So I go, hey, man. Tough luck. It was me, but I got away from that shit.
For me, so much shit slips through the cracks that at least later on there could be a possibility for justice.
Yeah.
That's my thing.
Whatever's gonna happen to me, I'd rather just stay there for life than to die.
If you committed a murder, no death penalty. If you, are a child molester, we'll cut your dick off. And yeah. If we find out that we fucked up, sorry for your dick. Here's $320,000. Sorry about your dick.
You could get a dick implant.
Oh!
Pump it up.
Yeah.
Just hang on one moment. You look very sexy, by the way.
Or dick transplant. That's what I meant to say.
I will be right with you.
It's like a nub. You're trying to turn it into a whole dick.
Miss, do you like big dicks or small dicks?
Small, please.
Okay. Gotta take the air out. Sorry, went way overboard on that one. Really thought you liked the big one. Sorry about that.
Thanks for watching, guys, and those are our thoughts. What are your thoughts? Don't forget to comment below. We want to know what you guys are thinking, but don't write anything that will make us sad or make us mad, because after all, we're Just Kidding News, and we're a very happy channel. For the last video, click up here.